Colleagues, my name is Abdurrahman Shuaiba. I represent Mubi North, Mubi South, and Maiha Federal Constituency. I'm from Adamawa State. Mr. Speaker, I rise to support this very important motion. The motion has highlighted very key issues. The first issue is there was a motion passed by this House on allegation of corruption and mismanagement of public funds, which the committee was mandated to investigate. The committee has not been able to do that investigation because the Ministry of Foreign Affairs claimed that the person to be investigated has diplomatic immunity. If the House has the powers to summon the President, the Vice President, and any other person to come before the committee of the House, I've seen no reason why anybody can claim immunity against any investigation. They have not even found it necessary to even reply, to even deny the allegations that was, because letters were written to them. They should have at least replied those letters, even if they are saying he cannot apply, appear personally, but we needed reply to those allegations that were leveled against him. There was no reply from the executive secretary. Then the second issue, these funds, Nigeria is the highest contributor. We are contributing these funds for the benefit of Nigeria. It's not part of the JTF, Joint Military Task Force contribution. That one is separate. This one is for the Lake Chad Basin Development Commission. Whether there is that military operation or not, this contribution normally goes to the Lake Chad Basin Commission for their own day-to-day running activities. So we have seen no reason why we cannot be able to investigate and find out what has happened to those funds contributed by Nigeria. Then number two, the tenure of the executive secretary has expired. He's supposed to vacate office and hand over. Why has that not applied? So why should he have diplomatic immunity and he cannot also obey another law that your tenure has expired, you should vacate? He should have vacated his office as at May 2017, even though he should have retired in 2016. So, Mr. Speaker, we should take this thing seriously. It's because we are contributing, that's why we are talking. If we stop contributing, maybe nobody will even talk. So we should suspend that particular contribution pending when we are able to investigate those allegations. We are not saying we should stop it completely, but we should suspend. Let's investigate. Let them appear. If they appear today and explain, and we are satisfied with their explanation, we can call on the House to lift that suspension. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I believe every member should be able to support this motion because it's a very, very important motion. We should not allow public funds, especially in this era of scarcity of funds. We have so many other things that we can do with Nigerian funds than to contribute to a place where we cannot be able to oversight. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I so submit.